Did you know that Adelaide has a sister city relationship with one of Japan's cities? Well, it does. And can you guess with who though? And what about how long it's been going on for? In today's video, we're going to take a high level look into this sister city relationship. Ikimashō. Minasan konnichiwa, my name is Luke and welcome to the very first episode on my new YouTube channel, Tokyo One. The purpose of this channel is to take you on a journey of discovery around all things Japan in South Australia. Over the years, I've started to realize that there's a bigger and growing Japanese footprint in South Australia than I had first thought, and I really want this channel to be a platform that will help shine a bit more of a light around that footprint, support the future growth of Japan in SA, and bring all of you along for the journey. As noted in the opening of the video, we're going to look into the sister city relationship. We're going to explore the city of Adelaide, the city of Himeji, and their long history of friendship. I've selected this particular topic because I think this sister city friendship has really paved some really good foundations from its beginnings up until now. Now, to be honest and transparent, from what I've learned, there have been some rocky periods in the relationship also. But let's be realistic here, not every friendship or relationship is perfect. But today we're just going to focus on the predominant greatness of the relationship. So before we dive into the highlights of the relationship and a bit more, let's take a quick look at each of the two cities. Let's start off with Adelaide. Adelaide, the capital city of South Australia. Adelaide is the fifth largest capital city of Australia with a population of around 1.3 million. Founded in 1836 and designed by Colonel William Light, who decided to design the city in a grid-like layout with five town squares surrounded by parklands. This grid-like design makes it very easy to navigate through the city, which is a really great feature of Adelaide. Just last year, the Economist Intelligence Unit's Global Livability Index, which looks at the world's city's key areas such as stability, healthcare, culture and environment, education and infrastructure, Adelaide was crowned the third most livable city in the world. Not only is it the most livable because of the housing affordability compared to other states in Australia, but when the state excels in areas such as research and innovation across multiple industries, you know you are, or even could be, living in a state with a very bright future of growth and prosperity. Couple that with world-class events such as the Fringe Festival in March, countless wineries like Penfolds, beautiful beaches, divine restaurants, and so much more. It's quite easy to understand why Adelaide was awarded the third most livable city in the world. Now, there has been some recent news that the Economist Intelligence Unit in 2022 has dropped Adelaide from third to the 30th most livable city. And it sounded like the main reason was because of the slow transition back from the COVID peak. I think we can all agree that the EIU might want to recheck which countries or states have come out of the pandemic in a lot better of a position than many others. All right, let's take a look at Himeji now, okay? Himeji is located in the southwestern part of Hyogo Prefecture and is the second largest city in Hyogo, with a population of around 530,000 people. Quick shout out to Kobe for being the largest with around 1.5 million. I did have to say that as my wife is from Kobe. Okay, back to it. So in the late 1900s, Himeji rapidly became one of the prefecture's largest industrial centers, manufacturing iron, steel, textiles, and leather goods. But the star of Himeji is without a doubt Himeji Castle, also known as the Shirasagijō, the White Heron, due to its elegant white appearance. The castle is both a popular tourism treasure and a World Heritage listed site. But what makes Himeji Castle so special compared to many other of Japan's historical castles is how resilient it's been over the years against many challenges. Challenges like wars, earthquakes, and fires. To this day though, it survives as one of the country's 12 original remaining castles. Now that's something to be proud of. Himeji is also famous for its hot pot dish, oden, which is eaten throughout Japanese homes across the country, especially during the winter cold months. Himeji oden ingredients are generally eggs, octopus, and daikon, which are boiled in dashi. And dashi is a soup broth made of fish and kelp, which is a type of a seaweed. Now, oden isn't usually eaten with any sauce, but what makes himeji oden unique and extra tasty is the ginger soy sauce that the ingredients are actually dipped into. Right now, South Australia is pretty cold these days, and I wouldn't mind having a bowl of himeji oden right about now. Okay, let's take a look into the actual sister-city relationship itself. The sister-city relationship actually began 1 year before I was born, 1982. So there's a bit of a personal fact there for you all. Anywho, moving on. But what I did find pleasing was to discover that the relationship was actually initiated at the South Australian end. On the 22nd of February, 1982, the announcement of the relationship was made. And on the 19th of April, 1982, it was formalized by the then Mayor of Himeji, the Honorable Toyonobu Yoshida, and then Lord Mayor of Adelaide, Dr. Arthur John Watson. The sister city relationship aimed to deepen mutual understanding, friendship, and goodwill through programs of educational, cultural, social, and economic exchange. And we'll touch on these a little bit more during the video. Now, in the first year of the relationship, 184 Himeji citizens visited Adelaide, which resulted in an economic injection of around $600,000 into the city's economy at that time. Now let's put that into scale. In 1982, the median house price in Adelaide was just under $43,000. So that's 14 houses worth of economic growth into SA off the back of this agreement. I think that's a pretty good way to start off a relationship. I've said the word Himeji a few times now, and some of you may have probably had a few thoughts come to your mind, and I think most of you would have thought of the well-known Himeji Gardens in Adelaide. If you haven't heard of the Himeji Gardens, in 1985, 3 years after the sister city relationship began, the city of Himeji gifted Adelaide with the Adelaide Himeji Garden. The garden you see today was designed by Japanese landscaper Yoshitaka Kumara. Kumara's son blended two classic designs of Senzui, lake and mountain garden, and Kara Senzui, dry garden, which features such as a small lake, a step rock waterfall, timber arch bridge, rake sand, and a veranda. If you haven't seen the garden, check out the link I've placed in the description box below. Someone has done a really nice virtual tour of the garden that is really worth a look. I would recommend, however, that you head down there yourself and take a walk through it. It's a great place to spend half an hour to appreciate the beautiful gift given to Adelaide by Himeji. But what I'd really recommend is to pack a bit of a picnic, as it's a great little spot to relax with the family and really soak up how good the garden actually is. I've been there twice myself for a picnic. The first time was at the beginning of mine and my wife's relationship. I took her there on a nice warm day and we enjoyed each other's company, the food, and the garden. The second time was with my wife and now daughter, who at the time was about 4 months old. We decided to head there on New Year's Day to celebrate the start of a new year. Now let's fast forward to 2002, the 20th anniversary of the relationship. At that time, 66 Himeji officials came to South Australia to help celebrate the anniversary. The mayor of Himeji at that time, Kazuhiro Horikawa, presented the then Adelaide Lord Mayor, Alfred Huang, a shachihoko. A shachihoko is a mythical creature with the head of a tiger and the body of a calf. It is said that the shachihoko are able to swallow large amounts of water inside them and have the power of summoning rain. In Japan, the shachihoko is often found on the top of castles to protect the castle from bad spirits and also against fire. In the case of fire, the shachihoko was able to use large amounts of water that they held in their bellies or summon the rain to put the fires out. If you want to see the presented golden shachihoko, it's currently displayed in the front window at the City of Adelaide Archives in Topham Mall. From 2002 to today, another 20 years on, this year sparks the 40th anniversary. To celebrate, Japan's ambassador to Australia, Shingo Yamagami, came and gave a speech to a small gathering at the Himeji Gardens. Yamagami-san spoke about how Adelaide and Himeji are a great pairing, with both cities being similar with accessing anything quite conveniently. The ambassador highlighted another similarity. As South Australians know, Adelaide has been considered the city of churches. Well, Himeji, which is in the Hyogo Prefecture, the prefecture is regarded as the prefecture of castles. It has more than 1,000 castles, which are still standing today all over Hyogo, two of which are the most well-known castles, one being Himeji and the other Osaka Castle. Yamagami-san also spoke about the importance of people-to-people ties, which has been very successful over the years. He called out the success of the school exchange programs where kids were able to gain cultural experiences and how it broadened students' perspectives. The ambassador really hopes that the next 40 years of the Adelaide-Himeji relationship will continue to foster strong people-to-people ties, but also trade and investment opportunities, as they're just as important. On another note, I had heard there was a model of Himeji Castle located at Adelaide Town Hall. On learning this, I thought I would go there and have a look at it myself. But disappointingly, when I arrived there, I was told by staff that the model had been placed in storage because it was taking up too much real estate. While there may be some practical reasons, the fact that it's in storage, I think, needs to change. The entire model, or even some of the model, needs to be displayed somewhere in respect to the relationship of Himeji and Adelaide, and not sitting under a cloth in some room. With the relationship between Japan and Australia deepening with improved trade and investment relations, coupled with the security cooperation through the Quad, this will no doubt have an organic flow-on effect in some way to the Adelaide-Himeji relationship. But the basic foundation, and just as important as the trade, the investment and the security, is the people-to-people ties. It's those schools and university exchange programs where younger generations get the opportunity to visit and stay in each other's country for a period of time. Experiencing each other's very different cultures and ways of life that will either plant a seed and potentially grow into something really special later on, or it may just leave a rich, positive cultural memory that you will likely never forget. But if you are, or were like myself, and that seed and experience wasn't planted till later on in life, that's cool too. Because that's the beauty of life, right? Everyone's Japan or Australia, hopefully South Australia, journey can and will be different to others. We all know that Japan has been a bit more conservative than other countries when opening up for the tourism post the pandemic peak. I know that a lot of people want to get over there for their next holiday, and it's a bit frustrating that Japan is being slow and gradual to reopen for tourists. The mindset of the Japanese is to consider the long term over the short term, so rolling out the tourism gradually could be a strategy for longer term benefits, rather than the quick sugar hit. As we know, tourism has already started up again since June, but very targeted to family and tour groups only. But it should become more and more relaxed over the coming months. Well, let's hope so anyway, because we're also hoping to be there this year like many others. If you decide to travel to Japan this year, next year, or whenever it is, make sure to put Himeji on your list of places to see in Japan. And now that you know Adelaide has got a special 40-year bond with Himeji, it will make the trip all that much more meaningful. And while you're there, if you happen to spark a conversation with a local and you start talking about that you're from Adelaide, make sure to add into it the conversation that Adelaide and Himeji are sister city relationships. Who knows, the locals may be surprised to learn of that connection, and a word and mouth flow-on effect may happen. I suppose what I'm trying to get at is to make sure to advocate Adelaide and Himeji, advocate Japan and South Australia, even if it's the smallest of ways, because even the smallest and simplest actions could create a chain reaction into something greater than it is today. 40 years of ties between Adelaide and Himeji has been significant, and have no doubt the next 40 years can be just as significant if we play our little part. And I suppose this video is my little part. Countless thank yous for watching today. If you want to discover more with me about Japan and South Australia, please make sure to hit the like and subscribe buttons. Also, please feel free to provide some suggestions in the comment section below as to where that Himeji model that's currently in storage can come out of storage and call this new place home. Watanabe.